So now move on for the next exam paper. September 2020, 6 marks to construct relative parsing table for grammar. The grammar are capital D derives L semicolon T, L derives L semicolon ID or ID, T derives int R real. If you want to try, you can try for the parsing int semicolon ID. See, for this well, you can check the given grammar of left recursion or not. See input later, I will take it. So take the first production, first step number one, solve. Step number one, the left recursion. The given grammar for the first line, D derives L, there is no left recursion. But now L derives L, the grammar has left recursion. Remove left recursion from the grammar, then it is look like L derives ID L dash, then L dash derives semicolon ID L dash and epsilon. L derives ID L dash derives semicolon ID L dash or epsilon. And third one is also not required, and first one is also not required. Then you can write the resultant grammar including those both the things. Okay, now we can say this is your resultant grammar. Okay, after this you can go for left factoring is required or not. Then you can check the given grammar, left factoring is required or not. Step number two, not required left factoring. You can observe that one, not required left factoring. Let me go for the next slide. The computation for first and follow set for the given grammar. Now you can write the given grammar, resultant grammar L derives P. After that you have a resultant grammar L derives ID L dash derives semicolon ID L dash and epsilon. The last line T derives int R real. For these things we have to compute first and follow. Let me try for the first set. First of D, the first of D is capital L, the capital L visiting as an ID. Now I can write only for the ID for the first of D. I can write the first of D is ID. And then we move on for the first of L. The first of L is the first symbol, that is ID only. Let's move on to the next one, first of L dash. The first of L dash is, we have a two symbol. One is semicolon, don't take IDs. The semicolon is also one of the symbol. You have to take first symbol as semicolon. Later you can take ID, the second symbol. It's an ID and you have a epsilon production. Then you take first of T. The first of T as int and the second one is real. Okay, now computation of first is over. Then you have to find out the what is the follow set of D. Let me start follow set of D. The follow set of D, it is the start symbol for the given grammar. I can insert dollar for the given grammar. Then you can look at the production. I'm not getting any D. Then I can end up with follow of D is dollar only. The next we go for follow of L. The follow of L I have in the first line. We are getting the semicolon. I can take follow of L is semicolon. Then you have to check anywhere L is there. No, I have only one symbol. I can end with semicolon. Let's go for follow of L dash. Follow of L dash. The follow of L dash is semicolon. I can copy follow of L. Follow of L is semicolon. Next, follow of L dash is again epsilon. I am doing follow of L dash only. Then I got only the semicolon for follow of L dash also. Then what is in follow of T? The last one, the follow of T. Follow of T. The follow of T is the first symbol. The follow of T is epsilon. Then you can include a follow of D. Then you have a dollar symbol. Then you can check any one of the production. You are not getting T. Then can end up with this is dollar. Okay, this is for your first and follow set for the given grammar. Let's move on to the next one to find out in for construction of the table using these first and follow. Let me draw the table. The four-step construction of predictive parsing table. For construction of predictive parsing table, you can take non-terminals. Then the non-terminals are, as per the question, we have four non-terminals, D, L, L dash, T. Now, inputs are semicolon, ID, int, real. See, as per the question, we have what? These are the input symbols, semicolon, ID, int, real, including that we should add dollar for your terminal symbol. Now let me trace my putting the sets production into the table as per the computation for the first and follow. Let me took for the first production on D. So D is the first one. We took on to the D, the first of D. The first of D is ID. You can go to ID place. I have to write the production. The write the production for what? D. What is D derives? That I have only one production. That is D derives L comma T. Because I have the first of, you can observe, the first of D is ID. In the place of ID, I am writing D derives L semicolon T. Then the question, there is no epsilon in first of D. Then no need to look out for the follow of D. See, then go for the first of L. What is the first of L? Again, you have ID. Then you have to write in the place of ID, the what is the production of L? What is the resultant grammar for L? L derives ID and L dash. Don't take the original grammar. After removing the left factoring, we got L derives ID and L dash. Okay, now we have to check. Then L have a epsilon? No. Then no need to go for the follow set. Directly go for L dash. The L dash have a two production, semicolon and epsilon. Then I have to check for the semicolon space. the semicolons, I have to write the production of L dash. Then you have L dash derives semicolon ID L dash. Then this production L dash have epsilon. Because of epsilon, we have to visit follow of L dash. Follow of L dash is also semicolon. Then you look out into follow of L dash of semicolon. You have to write the production as L dash derives epsilon. So you have to write the production of L dash derives epsilon because we have the follow set is semicolon. If you have a semicolon, then I have to insert the production L dash derives semicolon in the in part of L non-terminal L dash. Then look at the last one. The last one is D. That T have two things, int and real. There is no epsilon. No need to worry about that. You have to write T derives int, T derives real. Okay, now you can check for the table. You have a multiple entries. Yes, we have a multiple entries on the input L dash derives semicolon. Therefore, the given grammar is not LL1 because we have multiple entries on L dash comma semicolon. For this, we can say the given grammar is LL1. The 6 marks will be divided as left recursion is required, 1 marks. First, 1.5. Follow, 1.5. Table, 2 marks. The 6 marks will be divided like this. Left recursion is also carries marks. First and follow sets 3 marks. Table construction we get its 2 marks. According to that, we scheme of evaluation of your paper. Okay.